Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. God of love, you sent your Son, Jesus, into the world to show us how to live. Help us to be ready for when he comes again. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to Children's Church from Good Shepherd Parish. We're the Tea Bears, and we're very excited because it's a special time of year. It's the first week of Advent, and we have a special lesson for you. So boys and girls, for today's lesson, I want you to begin by thinking about things that you have to wait for. I read one time that if you live until you're 70 years old, you will have waited for 3 years of your life if you were to put all that waiting together. Now that's a lot of time spent waiting. I know that you probably have waited in line to go on a ride. Sometimes we wait for mail to come. We could have to wait for lunch to be ready. Sometimes you have to wait for your grandma or grandpa, or maybe a family member to come and visit. You might be waiting for your favorite movie to come out at the movie theater. Lots of waiting. But during Advent, the thing that we are waiting for the most is for Jesus to come. And during Advent, what we do while we're waiting for Christmas, which is Jesus' birthday, we try to prepare ourselves for Jesus. So let's watch a little video that explains about Advent.
Isn't this a special time of year? Things begin to change all around us, don't they? Some places begin to play holiday music. And decorations spring up all over the place. And you know what else? People begin to get really excited because of all the festivities that begin to take place. Yep, it's a very special time of year. But, well, in the middle of all that, it's easy to forget what the season is really all about in the first place. And Advent is all about helping us remember what Christmas is all about. Advent comes from the Latin word adventus, which means coming. It's like when you are expecting a visit from friends and family that you haven't seen in a long time. You think of all the fun times you will have together. You look forward to their visit. Or, like when you are excited about vacation time, and you ask,
how many days till we go on vacation?
You ask that because you just can't wait to do something special, right? In the same way that we look forward to things that are special to us, during Advent, we look forward to celebrating Christmas. That Jesus came to us as a baby 2,000 years ago, and that someday he will return, just as he promised. So, how do we observe Advent? Advent starts with evening prayer on the Sunday closest to November 30th and ends the evening before Christmas. One way we observe it is by means of an Advent wreath, a circle of evergreen branches with four candles. Usually three of them are violet, and one of them the color rose. Each of the four Sundays before Christmas, family and friends gather around the wreath. They'll read something that helps them to think about Jesus, and then they pray and light a candle in honor of our Lord. On the third Sunday, the rose-colored candle is lit, because the time is nearing for the birth of Jesus, which is celebrated on the last Sunday, when the final candle is lit. As each of the candles are lit, it reminds us of how Jesus brought his light to our world. Yes, it is nice. And you know what? There's also another way to keep Christ close to our hearts this season. And that is by taking some special time with him every day. That's right, Christmas. Happy Advent. Let's look forward all together to the wonderful arrival of our Lord.
I hope you enjoyed watching that video. Now, here's something I'm sure you guys all know about. It's a calendar. Now, we use calendars when we want to write down something important, or we write down events that we're waiting for that we don't want to forget. So here, lots of things written down on our calendar. Another type of calendar you might know of is an Advent calendar. And that might look like one of these. There's all kinds of different Advent calendars. But what happens is, usually starting in December, every day you open something up or take something out, and it shows that we're getting closer and closer to Christmas. Also, another thing you may have seen during Advent is the Advent wreath. And each week in Advent, we light another candle. So any time that we have a calendar or the Advent wreath, it shows that we're counting down to something important. And the thing that is important is Jesus' birthday, and when Jesus is supposed to come again. So, here's a little song that tells us a bit more about Advent. To get ready for Christmas. What have we done here, Eric, to prepare for Christmas?
We did some decorations inside our house. We watched some movies. We decorated the Christmas tree. And we did some letters to Santa.
Wow, so we've been getting ready for Christmas a lot already. Good job. So even though it's lots of fun to decorate your house and watch Christmas movies, the most, I guess, special thing that we can do during Advent is prepare ourselves for Jesus. We don't know for sure when Jesus is going to come again, but we want to make sure that our heart is ready for him. So some of the things that we can do to make room in our heart, it says in the middle, make room in your heart for Jesus. We want to make sure that we obey our parents and our teachers. Also, we want to share with one another. We want to repent. That means if you do something wrong, you say, "I'm sorry," and you ask for forgiveness. And then, of course, we have to forgive other people. We want to show that we love one another. We can pray every day. And we want to care for the people around us. So all of those things help us to be ready in the Advent season, be ready for Jesus. So up next, we have a little Advent prayer that has some actions. So try those actions along with Avery, and then we'll listen to a song.
4, 3, 2, 1, count the weeks till Jesus comes. Each week we add another light, our hope for Jesus growing bright. We pray, we share, we do our part, we welcome Jesus to our heart.
Thanks for joining. We're going to finish with one final prayer. And then after the prayer, if you want to go to the Good Shepherd website, there's some activities to download. Have a great week.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Father, we're going to celebrate your Son's birthday soon. We will be preparing our home, our gifts, our food. Help us to remember to prepare our hearts. Help us in all our busyness to remember it's your Son we're getting ready for. Help us help a friend, keep a promise, or visit someone lonely. Come, Lord Jesus, we need you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.